Professor Dave here. Let's talk about points, lines, and planes.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
As we just discussed, geometry was developed in ancient Greece, and when we learn the geometry of this time, we refer to it as Euclidean geometry, in reference to the mathematician Euclid, to whom it is attributed. His work, which built upon the work of earlier mathematicians, like Pythagoras, describes a set of axioms and postulates from which a variety of theorems can be derived. Let's learn about the physical constructs that these axioms describe, so that we can learn about all the math we can do with them. First, we look at a point. This is nothing more than a location in space. It is zero-dimensional, meaning that it has no dimensions of any kind. We represent points with little dots and some capital letter, making sure to realize that the dot we draw is infinitely larger than the point it is meant to represent. From here, we can construct a one-dimensional object by stringing an infinite number of points along a particular dimension. This object is called a line. Points and lines are familiar to us from algebra, but now let's examine a two-dimensional object. This can be achieved by stringing an infinite number of lines along a dimension perpendicular to the line. This is called a plane. And then, if we string an infinite number of planes in either direction, we get three-dimensional space. Point, line, plane, space. 0, 1, 2, and 3 dimensions. Another linearity we can identify is that a point is just a point, but any two points can define a line, since there is only one line that contains both of these points. Extrapolating further, any three points that aren't all collinear can define a plane, since there is only one plane that contains all three of these points. We should mention that these figures are idealized concepts. We can never create a plane that is infinitely thin so as to legitimately consist of only two spatial dimensions. Even a piece of paper has some thickness, even if it's hard to see with the human eye. But we can create mental idealizations of these objects and discuss them concretely, and the conclusions we draw from them will have application in the physical world, where we can approximate certain systems as being perfectly Euclidean. Just to list a bit more terminology, while a line extends infinitely along its one dimension in both directions, if we chop one end off, giving it a definite starting point, we call this a ray. If we chop off both ends, leaving some chunk left over in the middle, this is called a line segment. Line segments have two endpoints. Rays have one endpoint, and lines have none. We can use lines, rays, and line segment to generate all kinds of figures. We can make shapes with differing numbers of sides, and we can also create all kinds of angles between these lines. There is plenty to discuss regarding the types of angles that are possible, their magnitudes, and their relationships. So let's move on and talk about angles. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.